how ideas can change the world and how brilliant, you know, these founders are. They already know what the market is going to be like and everything. So while this discussion was happening, for the very first time, you know, a 16-year-old kid, it just subconsciously hit me that why was there not even a single female name in the discussion that we were having? To that, you know, at that point of time, I could just think of two options. Either maybe the female entrepreneurs do not get the kind of attention and fame that maybe the males do, or second, maybe they simply do not exist. So I was very curious, you know, I remember. So I went back home, opened my laptop, and I started searching. And to my surprise, there were thousands of names, you know. And I was shocked that why was it that I didn't even knew one of these female entrepreneurs? And trust me, you know, my 16-year-old ego was very, very injured. And I thought I'm so stupid, you know, I don't even know a single female name out there. So I just wanted to feel, you know, a little better. So I decided that the next day I'm going to go to school. And I gave this open challenge in my classroom to everybody, including the teachers, that they had to name any 5 female entrepreneurs, not just in India, but across the globe. And guess what? No one was actually able to name even 2 female names. Well, that, you know, that particular incident actually taught me a lot. Talking about entrepreneurship, you know, entrepreneurship is an ultimate path to self-discovery where any entrepreneur, male or female, irrespective of the part of the country they belong to, has an idea, go out there, hustle every day, believe in it so much, and is crazy enough to think that they can change the world. While they risk everything aside, you risk your time, you risk your name, you risk your reputation, you risk your self-respect, and most importantly, you risk your heart and soul. So despite everything being the same, why is it that the journey of a female entrepreneur, especially in a patriarchal society like India, is so multifold? You know what? The Google definition of the word female entrepreneur or women entrepreneur doesn't talk about girls in business or girls with an idea and who are doing great. It actually starts with, and I'm talking about the Google definition of this term, women entrepreneur. Women entrepreneurs comprise less than 1/3 of all the total entrepreneur population worldwide. So ladies, where are you? And to the ones who are already there in the business, again, ladies, where are you? You know, I'm sure you all must be thinking that, come on Srishti, it's high time, you know, let's not talk about women empowerment. And we see girls doing so amazing in almost every field, and there's no doubt about it. And you know, there's no debate about it. And definitely, you know, it's not a man versus a woman talk, especially in the era where the word feminism has got so much negativity. And trust me, you know, I had the same point of view, and you know, I completely used to think that women empowerment, you know, everybody is excelling and everything. But that was, you know, the scenario 3 years before now. I started working while I was 17, you know, and post I entered the so-called real world, my perception about it has completely changed. And I can stand here and talk about that, yes, inequality still exists within the equality that the ladies, especially in business, have been given. You know, a lot has happened over a very short period of time. And as I've said, you know, a lot has changed many, many, many times. Okay, so if I just have to ask the girls here, how many of the girls especially see entrepreneurship as a safe career? Just a raise of hand, if you know, you could raise your hand. Because I can see a lot of girls. Entrepreneurship as a great career. Okay, very few. Okay. You know, a lot has changed over time. And trust me, let me talk about some data and I'll directly come to the data. India is ranked as 29th out of 31 when it comes to the ease of doing business for women. According to an NSSO report, the women participation rate is only 4% in India, while if I talk about the US, it's about 71%. India has the third largest startup ecosystem in the world, and yet the women participation rate is still 14%. Do I still need to tell them what is the issue that we still call as a developing nation? I don't think so. Fast forward. You know, a lot of time times and a lot of people ask me that, you know, you do talk about women entrepreneurship and why do you think that, you know, still it exists? And I'm sure, you know, a lot of you must still be having doubts. Okay, data health, but what exactly is the solution to it? So I'll definitely come up to that. You know, I'm an undergraduate student, as I've told you. I'm still in my third year of college and I can see a lot of shocking places. Don't worry, I haven't failed any year. I look a little older than my age and I'm third year. You know, and every second day, I'm having this conversation with my friends. We are talking about jobs, you know. Ki, theek hai, economics honors karo, BCom honors karo. Jobs milenge, nahi milenge. Or, you know, despite having a degree, we actually settle when it comes to getting a job. And definitely, you know, the concern is very much relevant in today's time. Sabko hota hoga. Because 41 million Indians are still jobless. The current rate of economic growth is around 7.3% and we are looking for a 10%. The direct increase in number can only be catered by entrepreneurship. The question is, if we know where we are and where exactly we need to go, why is there still a fight for the Indian ladies? Can anybody answer that? Anyone? Okay. So out of my own experiences and talking to about 1,000 women across the country, because that's what I do the whole day, I have been able to derive three very beautiful set of assumptions that yes, do still exist on the basis of two main factors. Number one, a conditioned lack of self-belief that yes, does exist in the girls of my generation as well. And second is an ecosystem that completely promotes or supports. I'll share some of, you know, the incidences and my stories in which it's going to be easier for me to actually tell what I'm trying to say. So the first very beautiful assumption that people even today in today's era do have is that ladies cannot talk about big numbers and valuations. Women cannot talk about money. I'm sorry. Women cannot talk about big money. It is still a challenge for so many girls out there and the ladies, especially in the business, to have hardcore conversation. I've seen it. You know why? I remember approaching an investor with the same idea, with the same plan, versus my male business partner approaching it. I've seen it. Assumption number two. Ladies, at a lot of places and a lot of times, are not taken up very seriously by all of us. As I've said, you know, ecosystem doesn't just comprise of me and everyone. A lot of time ladies are not taken up seriously by the collaborating parties and a lot of time even by their own team members. Another beautiful incident that I can recall as of now is, you know, it's a very recent one, about 1 or 2 months back. I was very happy. I had made this recent, you know, aqua hiring deal with one of the established organizations in India. Obviously, I won't be naming that over here on this platform. And these two gentlemen were actually finding it very difficult to make a deal with a 20-year-old girl, and they were sitting across the table with me. And despite having the exact conversation as to where do we need to go in the next 1 month, and what is the strategy, what exactly need to be done, these two gentlemen, despite having the whole clear-cut conversation, chose to wait for 7 more hours on the same day to have the exact same conversation with my male business partner. So you can imagine how seriously girls are taken in today's era. And number three, and I'm sure all the ladies out there are going to walk with that. Girls do not support other girls. Come on, let's face it, that happens so many times. Since eons, you know, we have been taught to brutally fight against each other, that we have actually forgotten the power of collective feminine support. Because ladies and girls out there, it's high time, you know, that we stop getting jealous of seeing the other girl wearing the same dress at the party and start realizing the importance of this collective feminine support. You know, despite every doubting eye, every wrinkled and wretched thought of thinking, oh my God, she's too young, she's a girl, will she be able to do it, will she be able to make an impact? Whatever journey I've had has been an incredibly beautiful one, and that has been because I've always seen myself as an individual with an idea, hungry for impact, trying to change or make, you know, my mark in the world, and not as a girl or a boy. And don't you think that's how we should be seeing people? Let's see individuals as individuals and not as a girl or a boy. I know I'm just 21 year old and, you know, I don't have a very long journey to share, but whatever journey I've had has been a very beautiful one. Definitely because of two main reasons, if I have to say. Number one, is because I've been able to confront my darkest fear almost every single day. And second, that I was fortunate enough to meet the people who have actually seen me as an individual before they saw me as a girl. But you know, despite that, there are millions of girls with definitely more talent and more passion, but sadly lack the platform to showcase. And most probably, you know, helping them or building something for them is going to be the next big goal of my life. Thank you so very much.